Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. First, we're going to look at what happened in the previous forecast time frame from 5th of May to yesterday. And we see some clustering of stronger tremors, first on the 5th, that followed on a series of lunar conjunctions on 3, 4 May. It peaked 6.1 at Seram, Indonesia. And then on the 7th, we had a planetary conjunction, Mercury, Venus and Uranus. And I warned about that planetary conjunction. And we did see some minimal clustering, not all that much. 5.6 at South Sandwich Islands region and 6.1 at Vanuatu. We also see an aftershock, 5.8 at Taiwan. We can consider that an aftershock on the 10th. And then on the 11th, we had a Mercury, Venus again in a conjunction with Jupiter. And we actually see some minimal clustering, but stronger on 2 days later, on the 12th. That was 6.4 offshore Chiapas, Mexico, which did have an atmospheric fluctuation 4 days before the earthquake occurred. You really need to look up those atmospheric fluctuations on the website and also in the social media. They are significant. And also 5.9 at the Kermadec Islands region. Then we had Earth in a conjunction with the Sun and Uranus on the 13th. And that resulted in a 5.6 at New Britain region. Not all that much, but Earth in a conjunction with the Sun and Uranus, that should never be underestimated. It also depends on the positions of the other planets and the Moon, of course. That's what I tried to point out in the social media the other day. So now let's have a look at what we're going to have in the next time frame. It's going to be critical. We're going to have two critical convergence of planetary geometry. The first will be on 17-18 May, and that will involve planetary conjunctions as well as a right angle. And then we're going to have a really critical convergence on 22-23 May, and that may really result in some big seismic activity, possibly high 7, maybe even 8 magnitude. So let's have a look. On 17-18, we have Sun, Mars, Saturn in a conjunction first. That's not really a critical conjunction, by the way. Then we have Mercury, Venus and Saturn in a right angle. That's the only right angle in that convergence. And then Earth, Venus, Uranus on the 18th. That is a critical conjunction that can result in a magnitude 7 earthquake. Last time the Earth aligned with Venus and Uranus, we did have a magnitude 7 earthquake within about 2 days. So that tells you something about the potential of that planetary geometry. Then Earth, Sun and Jupiter shortly after on 18th, later on the 18th, that's another planetary conjunction coming up. So we may see some obvious seismic increase at the time and following this convergence on 17-18 May. Now let's go, let's have a look at the geometry in the solar system, how that actually looks like, because we also have some lunar geometry converging there. Here you see the planetary conjunctions in red. These are the red lines. And then you see the right angle in yellow and the lunar conjunctions in green. And as you can see, on 17, 18 and 19 May, we also have some significant lunar conjunctions converging with the planetary convergence here, planetary geometry. So we may see an obvious seismic increase. And again, it may actually reach magnitude 7 following that planetary lunar geometry. Now, let's have a look at the really critical clustering of planetary geometry on 22 and 23 May. We actually have only two planetary conjunctions, but we have a whole series of right angle geometry involving Mercury and also with Venus, and that's going to be very critical. And on top of that, it will converge with the full moon, and that will be on the 23rd. So let's have a look at the solar system, because this is going to be critical geometry, a really critical convergence. In the solar system here, we see a whole bunch of yellow lines. These are the right angle geometries with the planets. And again, Mercury is involved here a lot, and also Venus. It starts on the 22nd and it goes into the 23rd and even on the 24th. But I will cover the 24th and onward later on in the next update. Two planetary conjunctions, Sun, Venus, Uranus, critical conjunction, and also Earth, Venus, and Jupiter. And then also we see these green lines, Moon, Earth, Uranus, Moon, Earth, Venus, and Moon, Earth, Jupiter, just before the full moon. And this convergence can result in some big seismic activity, potentially reaching high 7, maybe even 8 magnitude. It depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust, what the seismic response is going to be. But I do expect an obvious cluster of strong earthquakes, higher 5, 6 magnitude, and maybe 1 or 2 magnitude 7 earthquakes is certainly possible. And it may actually be the beginning of a seismic storm in the last week of May, because in the last week of May, following the right angle on the 24th, we're going to have a series of planetary conjunctions. So the critical geometry will continue into the last week of May. So I think we should anticipate a potential seismic storm here that's really not unthinkable. And again, we may see 1 or 2 magnitude 7 earthquakes. It may even reach high 7 magnitude. And in the worst case scenario, it may go over 8 magnitude. Yesterday, we already picked up a significant atmospheric fluctuation, and that actually marked the regions in the Indian Ocean and up north, India, the Himalayan mountains, China, Mongolia. And these are, of course, approximations. We don't have technology yet to be more precise than this, but this was a really strong fluctuation, and it may actually indicate an upcoming larger seismic activity, potentially reaching magnitude 7. And this is significant. When will it most likely occur? Usually within four to six days. So if you look at the planetary geometry that's coming up, my estimate, or maybe even tomorrow already, that will be linked to the Earth-Sun-Uranus conjunction, but possibly following the convergence on 17, 18 May, so it would be 19 or 20 May, that would be a possible potential time window for larger seismic activity connected to this atmospheric fluctuation. And of course, 22, 23, but that would be about 9 days from this fluctuation, which is possible, by the way, because if we look back at 2023 with the Morocco earthquake, 6.8, a fluctuation marked that area 9 days before the earthquake. So sometimes it can be 9 days. In any case, we have critical convergence of planetary lunar geometry coming up again, 17, 18 May, and even more on 22, 23 May. And we may see a seismic storm coming up due to this planetary geometry. Always check out the website for the latest updates and also the social media, significant updates, atmospheric fluctuations, more details. So be sure to check that out. Stay safe. Until next time.